If we take a more flexible approach to the history of the Canadian Rangers, we actually go back to the dark days of the Second World War. It was 1942. The Japanese had already launched their offensives on Pearl Harbor and Hong Kong, and British Columbians in particular in Canada were very nervous about the threat of a Japanese invasion of the coast. The big challenge was, you don't want to divert resources that you want to go and use in the European theater to the Pacific theater against a possible but pretty remote threat. So the idea was turn to the communities themselves in British Columbia, where men were too young or too old for military service, or were engaged in essential industries like logging or fishing, where they could serve as a home defense force. So they could be given rifles, a very limited uniform just to show that they were actually members of an official military, and some very modest training. And in turn, they could work to defend their homes and at the same time serve as the military's eyes and ears along the Pacific coast. So they performed this role from 1942 through to 1945. Then as the war wound down, the decision was made in Ottawa to close down the Pacific Coast Militia Rangers with the understanding that perhaps in the future, some organization like this on a nationwide level maybe could be recreated if the need came.